Hi, I'm Michael Whitaker. I'm a professor at the University of Victoria, and I'm also the president of Geochemical Analytics Services. We're all very interested in the concerns about the climate change and air quality, and a lot of these things are due to release of gases from the Earth to the atmosphere. And we need reliable, robust ways to measure these gases. And up until now, we've had non-cost-effective manners to do this. And so we've come up with a new technology. It allows something to make these greenhouse gas measurements very quickly. We're measuring methane using a new technology that combines the NASA sensor with a drone to make really quick and effective measurements of greenhouse gases here around the site.
We're up here for our second mission, as I call it, and going over infrastructure for oil and gas and understanding where there might be leaks, and this will help companies find a cost-effective way to remediate potential leaks.
Today we're at a gas plant. They're very interested in the kinds of emissions that they have from their plant, which will help them have ideas of what the overall fugitive package is. So they're very interested in looking at new technologies that can make their way of life a lot easier.
This technology is a tunable diode laser-based sensor that measures the abundance of methane in the atmosphere. The laser emits photons, and you know, the molecules get between it and the detector, and those molecules absorb some of those photons, and we can determine the amount of the chemical from the photons that were absorbed. You can build many of these sensors because they're fairly inexpensive. They're ultra sensitive. I mean, we're making measurements at part per billion level, so you don't have to get right up to the source. You can be far downwind and make good assessments of the overall site's emission properties in a way that no other instrument can.
It's very important because right now we don't have a baseline for greenhouse gases, and what this will allow the regulator and industry also to have numbers to actually go out and actually figure out what really is out there as far as greenhouse gases.
So the long-term vision is that we are able to assist both the industry and communities and First Nations in assessing what the actual greenhouse gas package is that's being released in BC, Alberta, and around Canada. What is the amount of gas and where is it actually coming from? It comes from a myriad of sources, right? So landfills, livestock, and so on. So we really would like to get a handle on what are the true emissions that are coming up from the ground, from the different activities here in the province. And if we do make any changes to these emissions, can we actually quantify it?